My entire day, nay, my entire life is organized in Google Calendar. And guess what? I don't even spend a whole lot of time in there. So I'm gonna show you just how I do it with these 5 time-saving tips for Google Calendar. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google content. And today we're diving back into GCal because I'm gonna show you how to save time in Google Calendar. So if you're new around these parts, hello, nice to meet you. And you can watch a bunch of other GCal vids via the links in the description below. But let's jump into GCal time saving tip number 1, and that's to add multiple notifications. That's right, you can add multiple notifications for really important events coming up. So first, when you create an event in Google Calendar, the default notification time is set to 10 minutes. That's really great and is usually sufficient, but let's say you have a really important event coming up and you don't want to forget about it. So as an example, if we click to edit this calendar event, we're going to have our default 10 minutes prior notification. But underneath that, you have the option to add a notification. So you don't just have to rely on the default or change a singular notification. You can actually add multiple notifications to the same event. So let's click on Add Notification, and another notification dropdown is going to appear. So here you can select the notification type and select how far in advance. So maybe you want an email 1 week in advance as an additional reminder. And you can just keep adding notifications, by the way, if you wanted, if you have a bad memory and you want to be notified maybe every day leading up to the event. Then go forth and add all the notifications your heart desires. And speaking of events, the second way to save time in Google Calendar is to actually add events to Google Calendar from Gmail. This is a huge time saver. So let's head to Gmail and say you've got an email asking about meeting up at a certain time. Well, all you have to do is click on the 3-dot menu icon near the top of your inbox and select Create Event. A new Google Calendar tab is automatically opened for you with the event details already populated. Now, the meeting title is also going to populate as the subject line of the email, so you can go ahead and change that if necessary. But then just check out how the body of the email is automatically added to the meeting description. How neat is this? So, of course, you can just adjust anything you want, but talk about a time saver. Tip number 3 when it comes to saving time in GCal is to simply search for an event within your Google Calendar. Now, this is really handy if you had a past event and you can't remember when that date was, or say you have one coming up, but you can't quite remember when or who it was with or what the details of the event were. Save yourself some time and simply search it. A lot of you are probably familiar with searching in Gmail for an email. Well, you can do the same thing in Google Calendar with events. So from your GCal, click the search icon in the top right, and a search bar is going to appear at the top, which sure, that's great and all, but if you click the arrow, this little drop-down arrow in the right of the search bar, you're gonna bring up all kinds of advanced search options. So you can search in all active calendars or select a specific calendar you want to search in, and you can add keywords from the event title or other participants, where the event was, or even rough date outlines if you remember that. So if you know what happened in, say, 2021, but you can't remember when, you could add that here. And then just hit search, and GCal will bring up any and all events that match that criteria. The fourth way you can save time in Google Calendar is to set up and view multiple time zones. This is a massive time saver for those of us that work across different time zones. By default, Google Calendar will display the time zone that you are in. But I'm going to show you what my personal and work calendars look like over here. And you'll notice I've actually got 2 time zones set up in the left here, but then also further left, I have a few different clocks on the left-hand side of my GCal. If you click on the settings gear icon in the top right, and then click on settings, you can then click on time zone on the left-hand side. So right away, you're gonna notice those defaults I was talking about. So your primary time zone, and that your time zone is going to update to your current location, which is really handy. But here, you can toggle on a secondary time zone. Now here, you're gonna be able to select an additional time zone from the drop-down menu. And then you can even label that time zone however you'd like. So now, back in our Google Calendar, you're gonna have your local time zone, but you're also gonna have your secondary time zone here too. Now you may be wondering, but how come that doesn't look like the three different time zones we saw on the left-hand panel? Don't worry, there's another way to set that up. To display the three time zones like I showed you here, you're gonna have to toggle on that particular calendar view. And you do so just by clicking on that hamburger menu icon in the top left. So now we've got my two time zones, but we also have three time zones displayed on the left side of my GCal. So to get these set up, just head to your settings again, and this time click on World Clock. Here you can add as many time zones as you'd like. So I have three, but go wild if you want. And these are what display on that very left-hand side of your GCal, providing you with a quick snapshot of the time zone in those locations without you even having to leave Google Calendar. Such a time saver. And that brings us to tip number five on how to save time in Google Calendar, and that's to change the default meeting length. It sounds really simple and really easy, but this can save you a lot of time in Google Calendar. So you know how if you click on a block of time in GCal, a new event edit will appear? Well, by default, this is set to 1 hour. So if you find yourself constantly having to change the default length of a meeting to 30 minutes or an hour and a half, you can actually just change this default so you don't have to adjust it every single time you create a new event. So we're gonna head up to the settings again in order to do this. And this time, just select event settings on the left. Now here, you can change the default duration time, but cooler yet, you can also toggle on something called speedy meetings. Now this is gonna allow you to end 30-minute meetings 5 minutes early, and then longer meetings will automatically end 10 minutes early. So now when you go to create an event, you're gonna get a notice that GCal automatically shaves off that time from the event if you have speedy meetings toggled on already. Pretty neat. All right, it wouldn't be true to form if I didn't include a little bonus tip for you, and that's to quickly change the color of an event in GCal. Yeah, even if I can just save you one or two clicks, well, you're welcome. So you'll notice I'm a big color coder when it comes to my calendar blocking in GCal. So you can set the color of an event when you're creating it, of course, but what happens if you want to change the existing event after it's made? Instead of clicking on the event and then clicking on the edit option and then selecting the new color, just right click on that event and boom, pick your desired color. Extra mouse clicks be darned. You can also quickly delete an event like this too, by the way. So let me know what your favorite Google Calendar time-saving tips are. For me, it's probably a toss-up between the multiple time zones. Oh, that's such a good one. But also being able to search events in GCal. It saved me so much time. And remember, if you want more info on all that Google Calendar can do, you're gonna wanna check out those links in the description below. So that's how to save time in Google Calendar. And now I wanna hear from you. What do you think of these tips? What are your favorites? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more GCal content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.